Great Pyramid contains enough stone to build 35 Empire State Buildings. In spite of its great size and bulk, the pyramid's alignment to true north is virtually perfect. To this day, the precision of that alignment has never been duplicated. The pyramid sits on a plot of desert that just happens to have a solid base of limestone underneath the sand. It weighs 700,000 tons, yet in 5,000 years the Great Pyramid has settled less than 1/2 inch. It is also situated on the prime meridian of Earth, its east-west-north-south axes intersecting the only lines of longitude and latitude in the world that equally divide the Earth's land masses and oceans. How could this all have been a monumental series of coincidences? The mysteries do not stop there. The pyramids were constructed at a time when mankind certainly believed the Earth to be flat. Yet in the design and the construction of the Great Pyramid, we are faced with the truth that whoever built the monument could calculate the longitude and latitude of the Earth as a sphere.
There are immense links both to places like Machu Picchu in Peru, the Great Pyramids of Egypt, a lot of the Mayan, Inca, Aztec buildings. You find methodologies and architectural designs and structures that are so similar. It's almost like they were all sitting in the same room learning from the same person, because it's there.
Ancient civilizations did not possess modern mechanical equipment. How did they move and lift megaton stones? Some believe they were given a technical advantage from extraterrestrial visitors.
You've got to ask yourself, why would they try and do something that seems so incredibly difficult? The answer to why they would do that has to be that it somehow wasn't so difficult for them. It was easy.
There exists one very concise description of how these massive stones were transported from the quarry to the building site. The master builders had the capability of putting some type of a white substance, paper-like substance, onto the stones, and they wrote on it. And then they basically gave the stone block a push, and it moved by 6 feet as if by magic. Now, did that thing really move by magic? No. Some technology was used.
That is part of the solution. In order to really move massive amounts of stone like that, they would have had to have been levitated, somehow made weightless. and then just move through the air by some kind of device.